Hello, welcome to Public Policy Fundamentals. We're going to briefly look at what we've already covered in class, except a few things at the end. The first learning outcome, which introduces the module, the concept of public policy. So if you look at the introduction here, it talks about the significance of public policy, how it comes about, and why, no matter what form of government you have, you always have public policy. It's defined in many different ways, and the one that the definition that I love the most is the one by Friedrich, which says that public policy is a proposed course of action of a person, group, or government within a given environment, providing opportunities and obstacles which the policy was proposed to utilize and overcome in an effort to reach a goal or realize an objective or purpose. You see, then there are also quite a number of different definitions that I've provided as well. Depends which one you like, but for me, Friedrich one is the one that I like the most. Then also, there's also a section which discusses the relationship between politics and public policy, how these two things are intertwined. Okay, going back to the definitions, you will see that these definitions have got quite a number of things that they look at. It's clear that the public policies are governmental decisions. Public policies are actually the result of activities which the government undertakes in order to satisfy certain demands, goals, and objectives important to the economy or to the country. It can be said that public policy formulation and implementation involves a well-planned pattern or course of activity. It requires a thoroughly coordinated relationship and interaction between the important governmental agencies, such as the political, executive, legislature, bureaucracy, and judiciary. Public policies indicate what must be done, e.g., people must pay tax, government departments must pay employees. Public policies indicate what must be done, e.g., no one must refuse to pay tax, employees must not steal, rubbish must not be dumped at designated places. So, this literally summarizes the contents of the above definitions. Then there are characteristics of public policy. There are about 20 of them. You just need to know at least 10 of them. So you've already done that in the assignment and also in the semester exam. So I believe this is quite straightforward for you. Then public, then policy and goals. To understand the meaning of policy in a better manner, it is very important to take a matter to make a distinction between policy and goals. Goals are what policies aim at or hope to achieve. A goal is a desired state of affairs that a society or an organization attempts to realize. Goals can be thought of as abstract values that a society would like to acquire, such as health for all, education for all, public safety, and crime prevention, and so forth. Whereas public policies are concerned with the achievement of such goals mentioned above. So that's how the two are related. Then you can also read about public policies and decisions. Then also two types of decisions, programmed decisions. These are outcomes. These are routine or repetitive and do not require fresh consideration every time they are taken. So they're almost automatic. Then there's got non-programmed ones, where people would need to always discuss and come up with new decisions. Like, for example, the issues of coronavirus. The government, something that was never expected, which needed a new approach, you need to be contextualized, and before they can come up with a public policy, like, for example, social distancing and all those things. So that's what we call non-programmed decisions. Then values advocated for or sought by citizens, these are the values. Then bureaucratic actors in public policy, you've also met this question in your assignment. For the parliament, for the cabinet, then you've got ministerial departments. I think this is quite straightforward since most of you did well in the assignment. Then the learning outcome two talks about the policy-making process. It's got quite a number of stages. The first one is problem identification. Then this is the explanation for it. Then also the agenda building and also the explanation. Then the formulation and adoption at the third stage. Then the implementation. Then evaluation and termination. So you are going to do this in the last learning outcome, the issues of evaluation. Then the learning outcome three, it's about how bureaucracy affects public policy. So this looks at this relationship. Then there are models of public policy which are very important for the exam or for the assignments, which is the elite model of public policy, where the stronger people or the more privileged people in the society are the ones who are usually influencing public policy. Then the rational model, where we are making logically sound decisions in the public sector. Then there is an institutional model, where public policy is authoritatively determined, implemented, and enforced by political institutions such as the legislature, the executive, the judiciary, and the political parties. Then for the group model, or the group theory, which views politics as a struggle among various groups, such as political parties, pressure groups, racial and religious groups in society to influence public policy. In other words, they are competing groups. All these are competing groups. Then they've got what we call the incremental model or incrementalism, which views public policy as a continuation of past government activities or policies with only incremental changes or modifications. As an example, let's say, like right now is the BTP which is ruling. If UDC comes in, they just continue from where BTP left. So there's incrementalism, just increase from what is already existing. Then attributes of successful public policy, so you can also read about that. It's very important to know this, but this is what makes public policy to actually achieve its objectives or its goals. Then the learning outcome 4 and 5, I gave you guys a very interesting chapter by Kush, which covers these elements in a very excellent way. So you would see that the chapter is organized as follows. It talks about policy evaluation, criteria for evaluation, then policy evaluation types, approaches, and methods, then evaluation agencies, problems in policy evaluation. So those are the key elements, the key things that you guys need to master in this chapter. Let's quickly have a look at these with regard to policy evaluation. Okay, so policy evaluation, its nature and significance, like what I said last time, there are three terms that are in this paragraph that you guys need to know. The first one is appraisal. What do we mean by appraising public policy? Then monitoring, what does it mean? Then also evaluations. You need to be able to distinguish between those three. They are well explained in this paragraph. Then the criteria for evaluation, there's the first one, it's equity, then efficiency, then effectiveness, palatable optimality, adequacy, and public interest. Then also public participation and responsiveness, sustainability. So those are the criteria for evaluation. So we try to see, does public policy, how well does it speak to these 8 things, you see? And that's how we evaluate the effectiveness of public policy. The approaches, the types, approaches, and methods. We've got what we call process evaluation, that is the types of evaluation. We've got impact evaluation, the comprehensive evaluation, then evaluation approaches. You can also, there's what we call front-end analysis, evaluability assessment, process evaluation, effectiveness evaluation, then evaluation synthesis approach. So you need to briefly explain these. Then methods of evaluation, we've got benefit-cost analysis, cost-effectiveness analysis, then experimental method, then statistical surveys, then qualitative methods, and model building. So they need to be able to explain those as well as your methods of evaluation. Then evaluation agencies, we've got specialized agencies, internal units, maybe in the ministry, in the different ministries or departmentals or departments. Then evaluation by legislative committees, then by special committees. So those are the type of agencies that evaluate public policy. And then also the last part is problems in policy evaluation. One of them is goal specification, then measurement, targets, efficiency and effectiveness, values and evaluation, information and data, then methodological problems, then problem of resources, the optimizing dilemma, the unforeseen consequences dilemma, the equity dilemma, the partisan dilemma. All these are some of the problems when it comes to policy evaluation or public policy evaluation. So that's in essence what the modules covers and what you guys need to be able to understand as far as this module is concerned. So thank you guys for your time, and I wish you the very best.